Transitions and animations both control how HTML elements change from one state to another without needing JavaScript. Transitions require a triggering event and are used for single-step changes from state A to state B. Animations can run automatically and support multiple steps through keyframes. Transitions are often used with pseudo-selectors like hover or focus. For example, a zoom effect can be applied when hovering over one of these images. By default, state changes occur immediately. Transitions allow control over the timing and type of these style changes. The essential properties for a transition are transition property and transition duration. Transition property specifies the CSS property to which the transition effect should apply. If you are transitioning the transform property, it would be specified here. Transition duration sets the duration of the transition. Typically, this is defined in seconds or milliseconds. Adding the transform property to the hover pseudo-selector triggers the state change and activates the previously defined transition. Transitions also have optional properties. Transition timing function specifies the speed curve of the transition effect. The default value for transition timing function is ease, so we start slow, accelerate in the middle, and then slow down again towards the end. We also have other values here, like ease in, slow start and speeding up towards the end, or ease out, so we start fast and slow down afterwards. Transition delay defines a delay before the transition starts. This is also specified in seconds or milliseconds. Instead of adding all these properties one by another, you can also use the transition property as a shorthand notation to combine all individual properties for simplicity and maintainability. So this shorthand notation includes the property you want to animate, the duration of the animation, the timing function, and any desired delay. You can also add transitions for different properties of the element. It's common to use the transition shorthand for multiple properties simultaneously. In this case, we use the transition shorthand to add different transitions for the background color and the color of this button. Animations allow for the creation of complex movements through the add keyframes rule. For example, in an animation named Roll, we use from or 0% to start and to or 100% to end the animation. We can add steps in between like 50% or 30% to modify properties at these points. A roll animation can be created using the transform rotate property within add keyframes. This makes an object rotate around its axis, starting from 0 degrees and completing a full 360 degree rotation by the end. To apply the animation, use the animation name property on any HTML element. Also set animation duration to define how long it takes for one cycle of the animation. When a web page is reloaded, the animation will execute once by default. Adjusting the rotation speed at different points in the animation can be done by specifying additional percentages within the keyframes. So when 50% of the animation is completed, based on its duration, the rotation should be 240 degrees already. Multiple properties can be animated in the same set of keyframes. So if we want the box to move horizontally, we can add the left property to our existing keyframes. So at 50% we add left 400 pixels, and at 2 or at 100% we add left 800 pixels for example. Don't forget to add the starting point with left 0 to create a smooth animation. You can streamline your animation by combining equal property changes at multiple keyframes. This reduces redundancy and makes your animations more efficient. Let's say we jump back to an already existing background color for our box. We can combine the percentages where this value is used for the background color property. In addition to name and duration, we have more properties. Animation timing function helps to define the pacing of the animation and works similar how we control transitions. You remember ease, ease in, ease out, for example. Animation delay also works as we learned it from the transitions, so this is basically the waiting time until the animation is executed. Animation iteration count controls how many times the animation will repeat. Common values include numbers like 1 or 2 or infinite for continuous repetition. Animation fill mode is a property that defines how the animation should apply styles before and after its execution. Common values are none, forwards, backwards, and both. Forwards, for example, retains the style values from the last keyframe, and backwards applies the style values from the first keyframe as soon as the animation is applied. To see the backwards effect, it's important to add an animation delay first. Animation direction specifies if the animation runs normal or reverse. As for transitions, CSS also provides an animation shortened property that allows you to set most animation properties at once. This simplifies writing and managing CSS by reducing multiple lines into one concise statement. The shortened format can include all properties we named so far. Left out properties are set to default values and can therefore be omitted in case you don't want any special values for these properties.